when COVID-19 started, it came as a shock. It really was tasking. It really asked a lot of our mental health. So this is my very great friend. We volunteered together when we first started here, Dr. Giffard. It was a big decision coming out from something that I really loved. I was initially in general surgery, she was initially in nephrology. And we decided to actually stop in that path and come and work for COVID. And you move to a place of denial, then you move to a place of aggression where it's like you want everything to be perfect, but it can't be perfect because nothing is perfect. But as a human being, you expect it to be perfect. And so after a point in time, you get very tired and you realize, but there must be another way to deal with this, right? And it was only after paying attention to my mental health that I realized that I needed to be a little bit more conscious. I needed to be a little bit more aware. And it was only then that I actually, with the help of my colleagues, of course, counselors, psychiatrists, everybody who could have come on board, and I will be honest, there's a lot of stigma for mental health. And it is something that has impacted us significantly in COVID-19, not just the healthcare professionals, but the patients, the family members who are sitting at home worried whether their family member will come back, you know, the auxiliary staff, the kitchen who's under stress to ensure that they provide meals to keep these people nutritional-wise going. And what it took for me is sitting down and understanding my brain, understanding what I feel, understanding journaling, understanding putting down goals on paper, understanding the psychology of it. And now as I've been going through, I started my awareness in February. So I can tell you that I've come a long way in terms of growth in mental health. And if you can see probably in Ward 9, we have a board now, a vision board, where I try to practice as much positive psychology as possible, because sometimes we may not know what others may be feeling, even the patients, the healthcare workers, everybody around you. You may not know their situation, but sometimes we can give little pointers that they may not necessarily come to ask you, but if you give them those pointers, then they can use it to their advantage. They can use it at their own time. They can use it to say, okay, well, today I'll practice compassion. Today I'll practice ethics. Today I'll practice teamwork. Today I'll practice love. And as you put those core values in, as you remind them and remind them and remind them, you condition the mind, and so it helps you cope with the crisis that's actually happening on ground.
To my back, you could see this board prepared by our Dr. Chico. I mean, really, when you speak of resilience, you speak of those physicians who really have been here from the start. And this is all in an effort to help with the mental health aspect of just improving, giving us something to keep going. And this put together by her brainchild, and we're very appreciative of it. We're also very appreciative of our Cuban colleagues who really have been here again from the start. This is a debt of gratitude that we'll never be able to repay. And we say thank you from the bottom of our hearts and you, St. Lucians. We say thank you on behalf of St. Lucia. And again, we ask you to help us, help them. Our Cuban colleagues, they're missing home as well. The psychological impact of this on them is significant, but we need to do our part to help them. Let's let them go home to see their families sooner rather than later.